Can we start with your team news, please?
Well, from last Saturday, we have Nani is back available for the squad. And apart from that, we have, of course, the question about Hector Bellerin. He has gone, he's going every day through tests and the process. And we only know tomorrow if he gets a green light from the medical people to practice or not. At the moment, he has not practiced.
In terms of Mohamed Elneny, have you spoken to him since he got back from Gabon?
Yeah, of course, he practiced yesterday with the team, normal practice.
And how is he?
Fully focused and, as always, he's a fantastic player, you know, with a great mentality. And he's, of course, disappointed that they lost in the final, but he's very well, he had a quality session yesterday.
Finally from me, it's Hull, of course, on Saturday. Are you surprised by just how well they've done since Marco Silva came in?
Not really, because I felt they played well since the start of the season. They had not always the results. And the Premier League is difficult for everybody, and they lost some games. Bit unlucky sometimes, so they are a tough proposition for us.
Arsene, first of all, has it been a difficult week? There's always a lot of reaction whenever Arsenal lose. You lost two last week, so has it been a particularly difficult week?
Yeah, of course, it's been a difficult week.
In what way?
Because we are here to win football games, and when you don't win football games, we are very disappointed. But it's as well an interesting week, because it's a good test at an important moment of the season, and it's a good opportunity to show what we are made of, you know, and to deal with what matters to us. Is that the next games, what is at stake in front of us? We are, we have a big fight in the Premiership, we have a big fight in the Champions League, big game coming up, and we have still the FA Cup as well. And we want to do well in all three competitions, and that's why it's important we focus, respond, and as well get our fans behind the team, and because this is an important and very sensitive part of the season, and we have to respond to disappointment together.
How do you go about that? I mean, what is the mood of the place? You obviously have had meetings and so on. Are those meetings the same as the meetings you'd always have, or has there been different this week? Have been clear the air talks, or working out exactly what's going on?
You know, when you don't win a game, you have to, and we analyse together why we don't win, and it's important to get clarity about what happened and rectify what didn't work, you know.
There were some comments made by Laurent Koscielny that have been construed as almost questioning your team selection and tactics in the Chelsea game. First of all, are you aware of the comments, and what did you make of them?
No, the comments that have been made are lost in translation, you know, that have always been twisted. But anyway, the players are responsible for performance. The club works well when everybody does his job. The players are responsible for their performance, and that's all, not more than that. And I believe that the manager is responsible for the results and the team selection. The board is responsible for long-term decisions, and the club works only like that.
You said that the words were perhaps lost in translation. Did you speak to Laurent and just find out exactly
yeah, of course.
What he said, and you're satisfied with what he's told you?
Yeah, he didn't mean that at all, you know. But when you have a disappointing result, you know what you get. People who turn things around, and we are used to that. We can deal with that.
You mentioned in an earlier answer about making sure you had the fans on board. You, I mean, you may well have seen the picture of one particular fan who had a banner up saying enough is enough. I mean, was your response to that, and do you feel that's representative of a growing mood amongst the fans?
Look, I believe what is important is that we focus on the next game and do not give too importance, as you said, from one fan. It's not me is at stake, it's Arsenal Football Club and the season of Arsenal Football Club is at stake. And I think in a football club it's important that you have different opinions. Yes, that always happens, but what is important is that to focus on what is matters to us. And what matters is not the opinions of people, what matters is next result and how we respond to difficult situations. We fight with teams who have invested as much as not much more than we have, you know, and this is a period where we have to stick together and focus and respond.
I know we ask you most weeks about the contract situation, but when you have a couple of defeats and then you see a fan with a banner, I just wanted to ask really, what sort of factors would influence your decision on your future? Would it be fans? Would it be results? Would it be potential signings?
Look, what matters is ideally you want everybody to be happy, and but as well, I think Arsenal is made of special strengths, and that strength is well to be united when it doesn't go as well, and that's what you want, you know. It's very nice for you to take care of how I feel, but it's not the most important, you know. I'm a professional and I have to do a job, and that's what I want to do.
Can I just clarify a couple of points? There's a couple of reports today talking about Jack Wilshere and saying that Bournemouth won't be looking to make the move permanent. So I just wondering if any sort of discussions along those lines had actually taken place.
No.
There was never talk of a permanent move at the end of the loan deal. So you expect him back here at the end of the...
Yes, we had no, at the moment, we had no move from Bournemouth for Jack Wilshere.
And Joe Hart, just wanted to ask about Joe Hart as well, as another name that's come up. Is he someone you're interested in?
No, we have. I have three world-class goalkeepers, and I'm very happy with the three I have.
Just finally, because we'll get on to the Hull game as well. You put four past them earlier in the season. Are you? Are they a very different team now from the team that you played back then?
Face a team of Hull with more confidence than when we played them. And so we have to prepare well.
Brilliant, thank you. Arsene, good morning. Well, you've had these meetings this week and you've reflected on those back-to-back defeats. What's your analysis of what's happened in the last couple of weeks and contextually why it keeps happening around this stage of the season?
Well, it happened because, as I just told you, we played at Chelsea. It's a difficult game. And I think it was down to the fact that we did not perform as well as we wanted, and I believe especially defensively we made some mistakes that as a team you cannot afford in these kind of games.
Were you surprised by defeats in the last 2 weeks? Did it take you by surprise given what you've seen in training?
Look, I'm always surprised when we lose a game because I expect to win it before the game starts, and I believe as well we were a bit unlucky because the first goal was absolutely scandalous for me. And I think that changed as well the game because we started quite well. And from then on, of course, it put Chelsea in a position where they are very good at. They defend well and they are very quick on the break. But the second goal, when you look how the second goal happened, I think we can only look at ourselves, you know, and the third goal as well. But overall, it was a very even game on goal chances. The regret I have is that we didn't make enough of the chances we created.
Do you feel definitely the title race is over for Arsenal? Are they out of it?
It's never over. At least you have not to behave like that. And even if you think it is... I don't, but as well, we have not even to think like that. We look at the teams who surround us. We are all in a pack that is very tight, and where the fight for every position will be massive, you know, and like it has always been every year in the Premier League, maybe even more this season than ever.
And you've had this fantastic record of finishing in the top four. How difficult is the task this year compared to previous seasons?
Because it has always been difficult, but... the way we respond to our disappointment or disappointing result last Saturday is vital. If it is over for us, it's over for everybody else, you know, because we are all together in a pack there. So we have to first focus to stay at the top after, if you can reduce the distance with Chelsea, you never know. But they have an advantage. They don't play in Europe. They play for nothing. They have no midweek games, basically. So they have, of course, they're in a very strong position.
I know you get asked this a lot, and I apologise in advance for asking it, but I'm going to ask it. Can you confirm if a contract is on the table for you? And do you think the lack of a statement from you about whether you're going to stay or not, it is a factor, perhaps, that uncertainty?
No, I believe that, once again, thank you for taking care about my future, but that's not what you know. My future is in front of me every time I make a half turn. So what is important for me is that Arsenal Football Club goes well, and I dedicate my whole energy for the club to do well.
Answer the question about whether a contract was on the table. Is it on the table, can you say?
No, I answer that question every week. You know, nothing has changed compared to last week. And I think that's basically it.
Thank you.
Sorry to labour the point, Arsenal. Have you actually made a decision on what we're going to do and you're just not telling us? Or are you still yet to make that decision?
I have nothing to add to what I said last week.
There were quite a few tickets available for Saturday's game on the club's ticket exchange website. You've sort of touched on it already, but it is vital that the fans stay behind the team at this point this season.
Of course, our fans have been consistent and have a high level of expectation, as I have as well, but I don't feel as well. Let's be absolutely clear. You cannot be fan until last Tuesday and not be fan anymore behind the team this Saturday. It doesn't make sense. I think all the other clubs everywhere, we fight with Man U, Man City, Liverpool. There are big expectations as well and big histories, you know. So, and we are in a fight there where we have absolutely to be united or we have no chance to do it. You have Tottenham, everybody is in a fight there and everybody is behind their team. And we have to do that exactly the same, even if we had two disappointing results.
You talked about this in the past, but there have been occasions when it's been a difficult atmosphere, particularly at home. And last Tuesday, it wasn't great, was it, at times? Do you worry about the effect that could have on the team?
Not really, because I want the fans to be behind the team. But as well, I'm not fool enough to think that the first priority is us, our dynamic inside the team that will create and facilitate the support of our fans, you know, and that's down to the quality of our performance.
Because patience will be key on Saturday. Hull have been very good defensively, isn't it?
Yes, focus on what we do well, you know, on the quality of our game and as well. These players have been great players last Tuesday. They are still great players. 1 week later, you're not a different player, you know. We have to be have common sense a little bit.
Can I just ask you one about Petr Cech? Have you been happy with his form in the last few weeks?
It's difficult to come out individually on a player. I believe that Petr Cech is a guy who prepares well, who is serious and wants to do well. He was at fault on the third goal, but overall, I believe that he had a good season.
There's a report this morning that you might drop him for Saturday. Is that he's going to play?
Look, I cannot come out on every single opinion that people have. My team is not picked for Saturday yet, and so I have to leave my choice open until Saturday. But that was not at stake in my thinking at the moment.